नैषां मतिस्तावदूरो क्रमाङ्घ्रिं स्पृश्यत्तनर्थापगमो यदर्थो महीसम्पादरजो विषेकं निष्किञ्चनानं न वृणीतो यावद् शिशिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद टोल्ड There is a gulf difference between this material world and transcendental world. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, there is a gulf difference between this material world and the transcendental world. Actually, I told yesterday, I was discussing some point about how to start bhajan, how to do bhajan properly. I was discussing some point yesterday. Srila Prahlad Maharaj, in the first slok, which I started with, they are speaking, Na eshaṁ manaha, this my material mind. Somehow I try to engage in seva, but I cannot do it. I am not successful. Naishang mati stabat urukramanghin spishati. This material mind cannot touch the lotus feet of Supreme Lord until and unless that bonded soul can take bath and the dust feet of a Paramahansa. If a Paramahansa, if you are successful to take the lotus, mane dust feet from the lotus feet of Paramahansa, then and only then your buddhi, brain, can purify. Otherwise not. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking, there is a gulf difference between this material world and transcendental world. And that gulf, the color of that gulf is red. Actually, there is a havoc difference. Even we cannot say there is a heaven and hell difference. We cannot say. Because heaven is material and hell is material. So we cannot speak that there is the heaven and hell difference between transcendental one and material one. We cannot say. That gapping, that gulf is red and red. What do you mean by red and red? Red and red mean the conception of blood and flesh. Wherever, whenever we see anywhere, whenever we see anything, anywhere, we have the conception of blood and flesh, nothing else. In Chaitanya Charitamrita we find one nice sloka, Jaha jaha netra pare taha Krishna sphure. At the bank of Godavari, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was discussing some point with Shuddha Bhakti, regarding Shuddha Bhakti with Raya Ramananda. And very secrecy of bhajan. And there we find one slope, Jaha jaha netto pare taha Krishna sphure. A pure devotee is a paramahansa. When looking anywhere, he can see that there is Krishna, nothing else. The Advaigan Tattva I told you, the Spurti. Actually, until and unless we get out of this conception of blood and flesh, flesh and blood, we cannot understand anything about Dhamma Tattva, Nama Tattva, Vaishnava Tattva, nothing else. So, Prahlad Maharaj is expressing humble attitude. Actually, Prahlad Maharaj is the example of devotees. When Prahlad Maharaj discussed Nishingadev blessing Prahlad Maharaj. That time Nishingadev speaking that you are the example, you are the example. If somebody asking how your devotee, then I can give the example. I mean give your example, Prahlad Maharaj speaking actually. Yesterday I was speaking about Kapilji Maharaj and Devahuti Mata. Actually Devahuti Mata requesting his son, I mean Supreme Lord, who Kapilji, about how to get rid of this material world. Then Kapilji Maharaj answering, I mean advising, I told you yesterday what I told, the sloka. I told you yesterday in a slok. No, Satang Prasanga. I told you that Sango yo sangsate heto asasu vihito dhya sa eva sadusu krataha mokshadaram apavritam. He's advising mother and ma. Association is the mind. My topics is sadhu sangha. And how to understand Vaishnava and Sadhu, huh? This topic is going on for 3-4 days. Sangu yo sangsatir heto asasya vihito dhiya. Association is a must. You cannot avoid association. And if this association is pure, then you be sure that 100% you are going to come out successful. If association is not pure, then there is no guarantee. You cannot come outside. No guarantee. So association should be pure. Pure association. Yes, and if somebody speaking, that sometime I can do good association, and sometime I can do bad association. But it's a must. If somebody is speaking, Maharaj, okay, I can do good association for some time, in the morning time, and whole day I can do bad association. In that case, what happens? In that case, what? Prabhupada giving one nice example, you see. Prabhupada, you can laugh. One big landlord, his son is very sick. He developed tuberculosis, TB, you know, TB disease. Very shameful. He's very rich man. There is milk, yogurt, everything there. So how he can develop this kind of bad disease? That is the question. And that landlord became very shy. How secretly I can arrange his remedy? That landlord thinking. He inviting big Ayurvedic doctor, you see. Any amount of money I am ready to give, but anyhow you have to rectify my son. I mean, cure. Then the doctor came, Ayurvedic doctor. Ayurvedic doctor told that I like to discuss with your son very secretly. Nobody can stay there. Okay, you can do it. Then secretly he is sitting in his room and asking, my son, how you develop this kind of disease? Don't speak lie. Otherwise I cannot rectify you. You drink or you smoke? And he say, yes, doctor, I am smoking. I am in ganja. Ganja, you know? Ganja, you know? I am taking. You are taking ganja? I am with evil association. I am fallen into evil association. I cannot leave this. I cannot avoid. I will have to take it. I mean smoke. I go for smoking. The doctor told them, how I can rectify you? Then doctor told, you see, I can give medicine to you, provided one condition is there. From today and now, you will have to avoid smoking. Okay? And you will have to take this amount of milk, this amount of yogurt, this, that, curd, butter, this, that. Very nice food, protein, all this. Then when doctor going away, that son calling, doctor, please allow me to take money, to smoke. I can take your medicine, I can obey you. At the same time, you please allow me to smoke. Doctor speaking, then I cannot cure. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada telling, those who are calculating in their mind, that we can go for good association and bad association, both we can do. And we can go to Krishna. They are actually Prakita Sahajya. Prabhupada speaking this term. They are Sahajya actually. This way, you can reach Krishna. Even if you go on doing billions of life, day after day, birth after birth, if you go on doing, this way you cannot reach Krishna. It's not possible. So good association and bad association, it is a must. Nobody can avoid. But one secrecy is there. Bhaktivinoda Thakur very, very scientifically, Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving explanation. What do you mean by bad association? Follow my point. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, in a very scientific way, explaining. What do you mean by association? Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. If you develop some kind of attachment, affinity, then you are doing association. Suppose, without attachment, without any attraction, without any relation, there cannot be any association. Understand? Let me explain this point. Suppose you develop some kind of attachment with your wife, so on, friends and relation, you develop. Then you are doing association with them. Understand? But if there is no attachment, like Bhaktivinoda Thakur, like Srinivas Acharya, like Srinivas Acharya, and you see, Srivas Pandit. Actually, they have no attachment with anybody or anything. Some devotees, those Brahmachari and Sannyasi, they are speaking in front of me, Maharaj. If you speak this way, then how we can maintain much, society? How we can do arrange different kind of festival? Distribution of prasad. So many people, outside people coming to us. Then if you speak this way, then we'll have to stop. I see, man, come on, you don't understand my point, actually. You actually don't understand the point of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Actually, Rupa Goswami was speaking, if you exchange, six kind of association can be there. Dadati pratiginnati prichati gujjamak makshati bhungte bhayati chayiva sarvidha prithilakshanam. Six kind of mode of association. You will have to do. It's a must. You cannot avoid it. If you are 90% successful in bhajan, 10% due, some sort of maya attachment is there, 10%, still you cannot come out successful. 100% you will have to. Yesterday I was discussing Shuddha Sata. You will have to climb the platform of Shuddha Sata. If you are not established in Shuddha Sata, then how you can serve a Vaishnava who is established in Shuddha Sata? who is in the platform of Suddhasata. Suppose Guru Maharaj, my Guru Maharaj is in Suddhasata Bhumika platform. I am in material platform. How I can do? Suppose one Vaishnava is there, a fourth floor. Fourth floor. And somebody asking me, you please go to the kitchen and you can find 1 liter milk there, make it hot and go to fourth floor and enter into the room, number 10 room where my Guru Maharaj is there, you can give him for drinking. Then if the man, I mean devotee, is standing ground floor, he cannot reach, he cannot do this seva. Suppose, you will have to go to fourth floor, first make hot, then go to fourth floor, enter the room of Guru Maharaj, then... This way, if there is a big difference between Guru Maharaj and me, I am a material, Guru Maharaj transcendental, then not possible. Then how bridging procedure, what is the bridging procedure? How I can bridge up? That procedure I was discussing yesterday. Yesterday I was discussing point that you will have to do parallel Guru Vaishnava Seva and Bani Seva. Suppose you are giving the responsibility to do Guru Seva, but you are in a position which I can material position. Suppose. Then, but Guru Maharaj is so merciful, he allow, okay, let him do my seva. So Guru Maharaj, no, he cannot do my seva. Still let him do. This way we see, if not 100%, 90% at least, 90% or 99% case we see, those who are going to do pure Guru Vaishnava seva, I mean, they fall down. If you go to the history of Gaudiya society, you can find it. Then why this happened? Is there any fault with Guru Vaishnava? Then the answer is that Guru, you are doing Guru Vaishnava seva, and you find different kind of fault with Guru Vaishnava, you violate Guru Vaishnava. This way, you collect some aparad. Many devotees asking, we are doing bhajan for 70 years, Maharaj, 50 years, 60 years. Why we cannot get out successful? Why? I give one nice example, you see. Then I come back to the sloka of Rupa Goswami, you can remember. Huh? Because so many topics I need to discuss at a time, simultaneously, to make the point clear. So many devotees asking, we are doing bhajan 40 years, 50 years. So we are not successful. Why, Maharaj? I say, Maharaj, you say we are staying with devotees, pure devotees, in mat. My Guru Maharaj is there. We are getting association, hearing Harikatha, taking prasadam, chanting, doing Harikirtan, Harikathas, hearing everything, and doing parikrama of dham. But still we are not successful. I say, man, come on. You are trying to do some seva. Actually, very carefully you have to clear this point. In bonded condition, you can only collect some sukriti. You cannot get the result of seva. Be careful. Somebody can misinterpret in front of you. In bonded condition, only the thing you can do, you can collect some sukriti. Seva result you cannot give. Because seva is a transcendental thing. To whom to do seva, whom to do seva, who is doing seva, and what seva, and what do you mean by seva, all should be in same platform. Understand my point. Don't follow. Seva, the matter seva, whom to do seva, who is doing seva, all in same platform. Then seva, the term you can use. Follow. Very scientific. So you see, in bonded condition, only the thing you can do, you can collect some Sukriti. And ultimately, you go on collecting Sukriti, 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 you are gathering Sukriti. After that bumper Sukriti coming, then one day you can cut the bondage of Maya at a time. Evam guru pasanaika bhaktya vidya kutarena sitena dhira vibhrishya jiva sayamayam apramatya sangvrishya atmanam atho sangvrishya atmanam atho tejyastam. I can discuss this sloka. Very nice sloka, very important. You should discuss this point. They can, then you, one, if I am successful to give you the taste of real bhajan, then Gauranga Mahaprabhu giving me full bumper kipa. I have self-interest, you see. That's why I am coming here. You don't think I am, actually. If I am successful to inculcate this kind of seva feeling inside your heart, then be sure 100% Guru Gauranga going to give a bumper kipa. Gauranga cannot abide me, Nityananda. Very careful. So, actually point is that you can go on collecting Sukriti, Sukriti. It's also good. And some that day coming when you can cut Maya bandage and get a stuff business there. Important. So, seva, the term, who is doing seva, whom to do seva, all should be in same platform. Then seva, the term you can use, otherwise no. Actually, Sanghas, what point I was discussing just before? One minute. Huh?
Yeah, so many years I have been doing bhajan, why have I not grown?
So, many devotees, they putting complaint that we are doing bhajan, but why you are not successful? I give a nice example, you see, if you hear, you can start laughing. You see, you have seen, sometime in childhood, we play one Ludo, you see, some kind of play. We throw, one guti is, then sometime one, sometime six, this way. So two boys playing, one by one he is going up to 98, he gone. And you can find there is a picture of snake and ladder. You see, so ladder mean you are going up, and snake, bite, if you get, you can fall down. So I say you are going up to 98, after that he is playing on the game, he get one, then he meet with the face of snake, he come down to zero level. This way. And another example I give, perhaps you have a direct experience about it. In your life, I think you already appeared in competitive exam. You can find some competitive exam. In America, actually, 40 years back, they started this kind of exam. I mean, the examination, you see, there is 100 questions. You can find one question paper. There you can find 100 questions. Each question bearing one mark. If you answer wrongly, negative mark, negative one you can get. And if you answer positively, rightly, you can get positive one. Okay? And one boy, he appeared in exam. And he answered 50% correct. And 50% question he answered wrong. Then he 50 minus 50, zero. So they started laughing. Yes. This way, you are doing bhajan, I agree, but you are also doing aparad. This way, every day some plus minus factor going on in your life. Some plus is there, some minus is there. So if plus minus calculation you can do, you can find there is no sizable amount of kripa which can help you to get out of Maya. Follow my point. That is the only reason for you, for why you are not successful. So first of all, he is very intelligent. He put a simple one question in his life first. He put it one question before me up to now. The how to, what do you mean by good association, how to do good association? This Prabhu put a question before me. So for 3-4 days I am discussing same point, very important point. So you see, this way we are not successful. But if you suppose somebody is speaking, you are the Kripa Patra of Srila Narayan Goswami Maharaj. Somebody is speaking. But I don't see that kind of success with you. Suppose. Then what is the meaning? Gurudev giving Kripa. 100%. Vaishnava is merciful. Anybody coming to him, but it depends. It depends upon quality. I mean, according to pot, you can get kripa. Guru Vaishnava, Samadarshi, equal side. They are giving kripa. But my pot is leakage. My pot is very small. If my pot has some leakage, then kripa I got. 100% I got kripa. Everybody is speaking the truth. But that kripa, through leakage, all kripa gone. Kripa is liquid, you see. Kripa is always going down. Kripa is liquid, going down. So I got kripa. Also I lost kripa through that leakage. Leakage means? What do you mean by leakage? Leakage means fall, drawback. Leakage means drawback, fault. So, Guru Vaishnav, yesterday I was discussing many points I like to discuss. I am not satisfied after discussing. I thought I couldn't explain this point, they can misunderstand me. So, yesterday I told about Tulsidasji, one slok. Then I can go to Rupa Goswami, you can remember me. Tulsidasji told, Sadguru mile ved batave, gyan kare upadesh, kaila ka maila chute, jab aankh kare pravesh. What? Tulsidas want to me. Tulsidas who compiled Ramayana, you know, Tulsidas want to say, Sadguru mile, suppose you meet Sadguru, then what is the duty of Sadguru? What is the duty of Sadguru? To give Dibya Gyan, to inculcate Dibya Gyan inside the heart of who is inclined to him. First duty. To cut Maya. Dibya Gyan means automatically cutting Maya. And each and every step he will have to put some restriction about your acharan. Vaishnava, hey, don't do that. Don't go there. You are always speaking this way, where to go? Where not to go? Always you try this way. Don't go there. Don't take prasadam there. Why? They are serving prasadam. What's wrong in it? Foolish. Don't go there. Suppose I give example, 3-4 days ago, you can remember, Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj, somebody coming. Where from you are coming? Babaji Maharaj asking. I am coming from Navadvip. There is nice Harikatha, Bhagavad Katha, Brahmur Gita. Oh, really? Brahmur Gita going on, explains. Ah. Don't go there! Why? I am attending Harikatha. I am going there. What's wrong in it? Don't go there! Why? There is no Harikatha. No Harikatha? They are crying. Those who are hearing, they are crying, shedding tears. Tears rolling down their cheeks. They are falling down in earth. A feeling of ecstasy. No! There's a passive karma there. A passive calm there. Don't go there. Oh, really? But there's one devotee is explaining Harikatha. But he is not explaining Harikatha. He is taking, he is speaking money, 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 sweeter than honey, money, money. He is speaking. Don't go there. Then if that boy fighting with Gaurakishore Bhaja, what kind of, you see, this way when Guru Vaishnava giving some restriction to you, you should obey without any question. If you go on putting question, then Gurudev become fed up and stop speaking in front of you. Then let him do anything. I have no time. Don't do, because you should have a strong belief that Gurudev Vaishnav going to give 100% benefit to me. First of all, before coming to me, before approaching me, you should have 100% belief that Maharaj, Gurudev Maharaj can give 100% benefit to me. By my personal effort, I cannot seek my benefit, spiritual benefit. By personal benefit, personal effort, I can try. Any amount of your effort is futile efforts. Nothing else. Like foolish you are trying. But the very simple way, if you get in touch with pure Vaishnava, very easily you can come out successful. This point you should believe 100%. Shrutas sapungsam suchira samasya nanjo sasurir virta artha tat tat gunanu sabanam mukunda padar binda hidayeshu jesham. This sloka I should explain in front of you very carefully. Sutas sapungsam suchira samasya nanjo sasurir virta artha kat tat tat gunanu sabanam mukunda padar binda hidayeshu jesham. Those pure devotees, they are putting Krishna inside their heart and they are locking the gate. Krishna cannot go out of love. They are locking the gate. Krishna cannot go out of their heart. That kind of devotee, if you can have the chance to do some seva, that kind of devotee. Vaishnaver hidaya sada govinda vishram. Govinda taking rest inside the heart of a pure devotee. Why? Why? No, yes, no material desire is clean. Cheta darpana marjanam, like Gunjita Mandir marjan, Gundicha Mandir marjan cleaning, same point. Cheta darpana marjanam, same point. It's totally clean. And that throne, I mean that singhasan is there, where Krishna can easily sit and take rest. By the way, if there is material desire in your heart, inside your heart, Krishna can feel disgusted. Because material desire there, material desire there. So Krishna cannot take rest there. No. Understand? Actually, Tattva Siddhanta is deep. This, that Krishna is there everywhere. In every heart, Krishna is there. In each and every heart, Krishna is there. Not only that, any dust particle there, you cannot search even a single dust particle where I cannot find Krishna. Whereas you are speaking that Krishna can take rest only into the heart of Vaishnava, pure Vaishnava. Krishna is everywhere. Into the heart of that devotee, I mean into the heart of anyone. Akama, sarva kama, va moksha kama, udaradiya, explaining this point. Everywhere Krishna. But there Krishna cannot take rest. Vakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Dagar Prabhupada giving one nice example. What kind of nice example? Prabhupada speaking, one nice devotee, he is cooking very nicely for Krishna. Radharama, he cooking and he is making paramanna every day. Very nice paramanna, very nice. And milk is Indian cow with ghee, with clarified butter. He fry rice, everything. Then after that, cook. After cooking, after offering bhog, and those devotees are being served, prasadam distributing. After taking foo, 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 everybody, ah! Why? They saying, oh my God, the paramanna is so tasteful. We cannot explain. So tasty. But one mistake was there with you, hey cookman. There was some particle, stone particle. Countless stone particle there, you could not identify. You thought that is rice, because color of rice and stone particle almost same. He wasn't given to... Prabhupada giving this example. Every old devotee, they are taking prasadam. They like that paramanna, very tasty. But still they cannot take inside. They throw out of the tongue. Similarly, you are doing bhajan. As per your capacity, you are trying to do bhajan. Krishna can also approve it, because Gurudev approving, Gurudev giving Harinam Diksha. But Diksha, that Diksha, about Diksha, I can explain this one. How? Actual Diksha and presumed Diksha. Actual Diksha and false Diksha. Prabhupada explained, Ma, come on, I am not speaking, I am not criticizing anyone. So this way, you see, Tulsidas ji is speaking. I come back to this point. So, Krishna Hridaya Sada Govinda Vishram. Govinda, Krishna can take rest into the heart of pure devotees. There is no desire, nothing. Rupa Goswami Pad also explained about what do you mean we have a pure devotion. Pure devotion. Rondasamrita Sindhu. Someday I can explain this point. So, you see, Tulsidas ji explaining, Sadguru mile ved batave. Sadguru, it is his duty to put some restriction before me. Don't do that, don't do that, don't do it this way. I think Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj, among all Paramahansa, among many Paramahansa there coming, their position is not same. Paramahansa there is also category. All Paramahansa not same. Be careful. Very high discussion. Now I cannot discuss. Even Madhyama Adhikari, there is three kind of division. Preliminary first division, second class division, third class division, top class division. Madhyama Adhikari also classification there. First, primary division, second division, third division. Paramahansa also. So, I think we are getting maximum benefit from Paramahansa Acharya, so Gaurakishore Das Maharaj. Paramahansa is Acharya, but still his Acharyaship is very complicated. We cannot understand. Because he is Paramahansa. He is Acharya, topmost. Acharya means? Who is showing you how to do Krishna Seva 100%, all the 24. So it is, logically it is right 100%. Logically and theoretically, practically, spiritually, everything. Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj is Paramahansa. He is Acharya. But his Acharyaship we cannot understand. Very complicated. Because his etiquette, Vaishnava Acharan, we cannot understand. Very complicated. Bhangsidas Babaji Maharaj's etiquette is very complicated. We cannot understand why he is doing this. He is doing bhakti. Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj. He is going to a low class, low caste, sapacha. Those who are, doing a scavenging job, cleaning job, road cleaning, jharudar, sweeper. And Surya Kundo, where I was there, long years ago, I was there. There Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj's bhajan kuti is there, still today, Surya Kund. Gaurakishore Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj going to the room of a sweeper to beg bread from him. many times I explain this point. All Brajavas, they become like, why? You gone mad, Baba? Huh? There is some Brahmin family, you can get bread then from there. Babaji Maharaj said, you foolish. I am foolish. Yes. It is Brajadham, where you can get sweeper and Brahman, Shudra, where is you can Brahman, Vaishya, where you can classification. This is Brajadham. Sapacha Grihate Mangya Khaibo, Pibo Saraswati Jav. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Oh my God. Babaji Maharaj don't care. He straightway go to the room up there. Hey, give bread to me. That sweeper coming out. Oh Baba, why you are coming to my room? No bread. You go. Because people, those Brajavasis, they can beat me if I give bread to you. No, you give bread. There is no bread. There is no bread. Yes, there is bread inside your room. It is kept 10 breads there. 10 breads you count, 10 breads there, you give 2 out of that. He stunned. Really so? 10 breads. Yesterday he made 10 breads there. He took bread. After there so many fighting with Bhajavasi, then Babaji Maharaj said, I am not going to stay here. I am going to Gaurdham. At the age of 125, Babaji Maharaj coming into Gaurdham, Navadvip. Coming here. So you see, that Paramahansa state, his efficacy, his behavior, is out of your imagination. So it is good, it is good if you approach a pure devotee, but who is speaking Harikatha, exhibiting Acharan, I mean acting as Acharya. They are also Acharya. But active Acharya means, whose acharan you can understand and you can try to follow. That's why Prabhupada, Paramahansa Sreshtha, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami, still he purposely coming down to the platform of Madhyama Adhikari to preach, to get in contact with common people, so that they can understand at least my mood, attitude. Jnanonishtho viraktova madbhaktova anapekshakaha sa lingyanam ashramam stekta charet abhidhi gocharaha. Jnanonishtho viraktova madbhaktova anapekshakaha sa lingyanam ashramam stekta charet abhidhi gocharaha. They are beyond any rules. Paramahansa, Bhagavan Sri Krishna explaining before Uddhava Sandesh. Now in between, I was discussing about one sloka from third canto. What sloka? Suta sapungsam suchira samasya nanjasa suribhita artha tat tat gunana savanam mukunda padara binda hideshu jesu. Why I should explain this sloka? You can get some scope to do proper bhajan. You can try to develop scholarship, proficiency. You can try, because you can get both clapping and money, both you can get at a time. So who is going to miss this chance? Who is going to miss it? But I am not a professor. I can discuss this point after. So, sutasya pungsam suchira samasya. With great effort, you can try to memorize scripture, authentic scripture, Veda, Purana, Vedanta, and you can speak in front of thousands of people. But that is not your success. Because feeling is most important. If you don't have any direct feeling of seva, then who man care to hear from you? If you don't have any direct feeling of seva, if one sadhu doing direct seva, you can easily understand. If you stay 1 minute in front of a pure devotee, you can understand some sort of hot climate there. You can understand. Very easily, because they are speaking all about their practical experience, what they feel in their life. They are not memorizing any philosophy and speaking in front of you. Not speaking. So, if you can, as I have seen so many devotees, so-called devotees, they spend their life whole for Vyakaran, this, that, to get professors, to get some degree, this, that. But they are not successful in bhajan. They fall down, go to family, this way. So this sloka giving me nice advice. So sutasvapungsam suchira samasya. Suchira samasya. Suchira samasya. Sramasya. Samas mane. Sram mane effort. Labor, with great labor you are putting. To learn Bhagavatam, Ramayana, this, that, Ved, Vedanta, Vyakaran. But after that you are not successful. But you can do one thing very easily. What is that? Those devotees, those who are Paramahansa Shrestha, they are putting Krishna inside their heart and lock the gate so that Krishna cannot go out. So you can do one thing very easily. You can approach that kind of sadhu with how to approach? How to approach? Body, mind and speech. Three mode of action. Sometime Guru Maharaj used to make joking with me. Guru Maharaj speaking, I am staying in old age. Guru Maharaj speaking, you see, he is paying dandavat to me for 5 minutes. He is falling down his ground, prostrated dandavat. You see my son, he is paying dandavat 5 minutes for a long time. Then after praying, he gone. Guru Maharaj say, he is paying dandavat to me. Paying dandavat to me. Physically. He is paying dandavat to me orally. I mean, from mouth. Bancha kalpadru sikvasandhi bai patyang varma. But he is not paying me dandavat mentally. Guru Maharaj speaking. He is not paying me dandavat from mentally. He is not. So that dandavat is not actually perfect dandavat. See, you are not getting a result of Vaishnava dandavat. Why? Because the dandavat is wrong dandavat. It is not flawless dandavat. So dandavat should be pure. Then you can get result. With body, mind and speech, you should approach a pure devotee. Then and only then you can get the result. And Krishna and Bhagavad Gita are swinging. Speaking, they can give knowledge to you, they can impart pure knowledge, spiritual knowledge to you. Because if you can do seva, sevaya, if you can do pure seva, then you can give. Otherwise not. Many points to discuss, anyway I can miss time actually. Actually, in this sloka you can find, if you approach one pure devotee, mind, heart and body, then you can get the result, and that devotee is trying to get kripa for long, he is trying to memorize sloka, going this, that, with Vedanta, but he is not successful, but you are successful. You are doing seva for very short period. But you are successful because sutasvapungsam suchira samasya nanjo sasuri vihitartham. Very, you can come out, you cannot come out successful very easily. You cannot come out. But if you do seva of this kind of your devotee, I mean here there, if you can have the chance to hear their harikatha, if you have the chance to see their etiquette, Vaishnava etiquette, if you can harmonize their etiquette, what you understand, if you can harmonize, harmonize, you will have to harmonize it properly. Then you can come out. Nanjo sasuri viritattva, tattvat gunanu sabanam mukunda padar vinda hideshu yesham. Jin loka, jin paramahansa vishnavokka, hidaya me bhagavan avadh hai. Inke charan bandhan, charan seva karo, unka jivani, their life history, I mean, aprakito Jivani. If you hear about their activities and Vaishnava Seva, then you can come out successful very easily. Very easily. Very quickly. Otherwise not. Now I go back to the sloka and of Rupa Goswami Pada. Dadati pati kinnadi prichati gujjamachati bhungte bhajayati. There's six kind of moon. So it's a must. You cannot avoid it. So association is the must. You cannot give guarantee. You cannot put guarantee. You cannot challenge that you can conquer Maya. You cannot put challenge. Mama Maya Duratteya. Bhagavan says, nobody can put challenge in front of me that I can come out successful, I can cut Maya. Who can? Is there anybody? Even Brahma, even Sankha, they are also hypnotized, overwhelmed by Maya. So who is going to put challenge in front of Yogamaya? Mahamaya. Nobody. Mahamaya Durattaya. Understand my point. So association is a must. And in my daily life, in daily bhajan life, some kind of bad association, some kind of wrong association must. Because I cannot calculate, because my logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of that absolute truth. And Gurudev giving me advice on absolute truth, about absolute truth, I cannot grasp, I cannot digest. So what to do? Guru Maharaj speaking so heavily, so tough, don't go there, don't take prasadam there. Why? They are serving prasadam, come on man. I went to Bombay many years back for some reason. Actually, I don't go to foreign country, nowhere I don't. I am less interested. But somehow, I was bound to go there. Anyway, there I went there. Someday, I went to one society, I mean temple, big temple. I cannot speak the name because I am not going to criticize. I went to that temple, and they heard about me. Actually, when they heard the name of my Guru Maharaj, they stand up from chair and paid dandavat to me. A second in charge, he was South Indian. He said, Maharaj, so long you are going to stay here, I give so many, paper to you. You can come anytime. You can stay, get prasadam here. You are allowed free. So he is giving me, I cannot insult him. I took it. But not even a single day, one single day, I don't go there. I didn't went there. Even once. Didn't take prasadam. Didn't stay there. Because I know there is contamination. But I cannot speak the name. Because my mood is not to criticize somebody, to make you understand the point. I couldn't take prasadam there, I couldn't stay there, only I pay honor to them, outward. Because situation there never permit me to take prasadam there. Contamination. So I couldn't take prasadam. So this way, it depends who is cooking, who is serving, who is offering to Krishna, all depends. Who is Gurudev? How the Gurudev? Why is disciple? How? Who is offering? Who is cooking? All depends upon. But in Puri, you cannot fight. Puri only 100% you are sure the Mahaprasadam is there. Even some low caste people is taking prasadam. You can go and take prasadam uchishta from there. It is allowed there. But there is no guarantee that everywhere they are making, they are offering pure bhoga to Krishna, and Krishna accepting it, and you are getting prasad. Not that. Don't fight with this point with somebody. Anyway, they can become very angry if I explain this. This must. So you must be very careful. Don't insult them. Don't criticize. But to protect your bhajan, so many points are there. I was speaking about leakage. If you can cover up your leakage, then you can find power gathering, power accumulating. Otherwise, no. Very dangerous. So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur now explaining, what do you mean by association? Just now I told you, one hour before I think. Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, if there is no attachment, no affinity, no relationship, there is no association. Huh? We are meeting so many people in train and bus, here, there, in boat. Who care, man? Huh? We have relation? So, anyway, we are asking, hey, that train going there? We are asking. So, we are not doing association. Suppose thousands of people coming to my temple to take prasadam today, and I have the responsibility to serve them, and Rupa Goswami already told Dadati Patakindati, Hari, then I am going to meet with bad association. Dadati Patakindati, I am going to serve prasadam. Then how I can avoid? Prabhupada saying, you are foolish actually. Actually, so many people coming there to take prasadam. I have my responsibility to take prasadam. I can serve prasadam. I have no idea because I have delegated authority. I have to take prasadam. I can spread prasadam. But without any attachment. Right? And now one very secret point here. Very careful. So many positive and negative points. Then you can put question before me, Maharaj. Haridas Thakur. Huh? He got the association of a pros. Yesterday he told. I told, no, come on man. He is not doing the association of pros. Rather, he is giving his highest association, giving to pros to deliver. So those who are Paramahamsa Acharya, maybe thousands of people coming to them. So many women, Matajis, Pitajis, they are coming to. But they are not doing association. In fact, that Acharya, that Vaishnava giving his pure association to them to deliver. Follow my point. So if you are a big Acharya, big sadhu, then you can do one thing. You can give prasadam to those bonded souls in your own hand to deliver them. I can give you an example again. So many examples I can give you. Bhaktivinoda Thakur in his Sananda Sukhata Gunja doing bhajan very nicely. Always his side close up doing bhajan. Sometime Bhaktivinoda Thakur doing one thing. He called one Kirtaniya team, Kirtan team from Santipur. They are all Sahajiya. Bhaktivinoda Thakur called them. Hey, come, do Kirtan here. And again, Bhaktivinoda Thakur can pay something to them. Doing nice Kirtan with so many here like Krishna. They put oil and everything, sand in body. So nice Kirtan going on. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur sitting in a pure asan. Bhaktivinoda with closed eyes doing Harinam. And so many people from outside road and here, they got information. One nice Kirtaniya team coming from Santipur. We must attend this function. It's very nice. We can enjoy Kirtan. They are coming. They are watching Kirtan. They are dancing. And they are also getting some prasadam. Bhaktivinoda Thakur arranging some prasadam. And also, they have the scope. They have the chance to look at Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Close eyes, doing Harinam. After Bhaktivinoda Thakur gone, in the year of 1914, people started fighting with Prabhupada. You are so tough! Huh? We saw Bhaktivinoda Thakur always allying the Kirtaniya, this, they are coming, doing Kirtan, this, that. You are so tough! Huh? Why you are so tough? Bhaktivinoda Thakur, very easy. Prabhupada laughing. Come on, foolish you are. Bhaktivinoda Thakur never allow this kind of sahajiya niti. Then we saw him inviting the Kirtaniya party. We saw. You saw. But that is not correct. Correct? Then what do you mean? Actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, like a fisherman, used to put one net so that fish can come and catch the. This way, it was a kind of. This way, Bhaktivinoda Thakur put one. one net inside. Oh, really? How? And actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur not hearing even a single sound vibration of material sound kirtan. He is sitting there, come on man, he is doing harina. Bhaktivinoda Thakur not hearing even a single word of that kirtan. Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to Vrindavan, already in Vrindavan, here in Vrindavan. But outside people, they have the chance to look at Bhaktivinoda Thakur. They have the chance to look at Bhaktivinoda Thakur, then they can accumulate, gather some Sukriti. And also Bhaktivinoda Thakur allows some Mahaprasadam there. They have the chance. So today or tomorrow, this life or next life, oh, they are bound to come in Gaur Bhajan. Because Bhaktivinoda Thakur give a nice chance to them. But people cannot understand. They fight with Prabhupada. Understand? This way, if you are an elevated soul, Vaishnava, then you can go to the house of a pros to give nice association to her. Like Haridas Thakur. Haridas Thakur, Vaishnava give the chance to that pros to get the highest association. He cannot imagine in his whole life. So Haridas Thakur giving highest association. Sometime we find Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, Bhakti Puri Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Madhu Goswami, they are doing bad association, Maharaj. But you are speaking so much Harikatha to us, but they are doing bad association. No! They are not doing bad association. This is the top secrecy of bhajan. Be careful. So the Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking right way. So you are serving prasadam, two procedures. One is you are bonded soul. So by the order of Gurudev, you are serving prasadam, but you have no attachment. But at present we see some Brahmacharya Sannyasi, they have some relationship with Mayadevi. They are giving so many prasadam to them. And outside gate, some poor people asking, give me prasadam, they are not giving. To some Mataji, he is giving some big amount of prasadam. Yes. Some beggar is poor, he came and gave. Hey, a little prasadam I need. He is throwing him. He threw him. He fell down and crying. Madhubu Sima saw. Why you throw him? Guru Maharaj is disturbing. Prasadam, prasadam, prasadam. He is asking for prasadam, na? He is asking from prasadam, na? Kripa, huh? Prasadam means kipa. You are throwing him out. He is crying, old man. Come on. Oh my God, you are demon. Let him come and take prasadam. Prasadam kipa. Someday some devotee, so-called devotee, is giving advice to Gurudev. Bhakti Yudhu Mahaparampajana Gottu Yudhu Madhugusima. Because Bhakti Yudhu Madhugusima used to travel around the spot where prasadam is being served. It was the seva of Madhugusima. He is watching. Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, hey, give Paramananda to him. He liked Paramananda. Then, someday, some devotee is serving prasadam, Paramananda. Some Ghosh, you know, those are coward men in Dhamma. They are getting two big pot to get prasadam for home. They are taking sufficient prasadam. After that, they carry one pot in which they can put Paramananda and go to home, distribute. And that devotee who is serving, he become very angry. Hey! You are taking prasadam, again you are putting in pot to take it home. Why? I cannot give prasadam to you. Madhu Goswami Maharaj. Madhu Goswami Maharaj come. My son, what they want? Guru Maharaj, look, he is taking so many prasadam, eating, after that taking prasadam for home. Guru Maharaj asks him, Paramaya Madhu Goswami Maharaj asking, you already took prasadam to Bhat Bambhashari. Madhu Goswami said, no, his situation. Madhu Goswami asking, you already took prasadam? Yes, Maharaj. Sufficient prasadam? Yes. You need any more prasadam? No. Then give to him. Let them take prasadam to home. Let them take sufficiently. Let them throw in front of dog. That is not your lookout. That is not your lookout. Give them. You need any prasadam, I can give you. Why you fight with them? you need any prasadam anymore? Eh? At present, this kind of feast, festival, everything, it become a material anusthan. I can explain from Gita. Someday I have the chance. Please remember me this point. Why this kind of function become material function at present? They can fight with me, but I can prove 100%. As per Gita, Bhaktivinoda Thakur explanation I can give. I can explain. It is not 100% spiritual anusthan. It became material. Because some material people engage. The money coming is material money, black money. Who is cooking is black money. His heart is not pure. Who is offering the total harikatha? There is not pure harikatha. Because they just arrange one mic and this, that, yes. That is why Prabhupada told, when somebody putting, you are putting so much restriction, where to go, where not to go. Prabhupada said, at least you can go where Namaparad is not being kirtan, meaning chant. Where there is no Namaparad, there at least you can go. Namabash. At least, I don't allow you to go, but still if you like to go, you can go there. So restriction there. I can prove from Gita what Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking in Gita. Any kind of anusthan, festival, if all material thing is involved, if you have no power to spiritualize, then it's not material. There should be one acharya, who is big acharya. At that time of Parampujivad Bhakti Pramod Purvishi Maharaj, at that time of Bhakti Vidya Madhava Goswami Maharaj, at the time of Srila Paramahansa Keshav Goswami Maharaj, they are in temple. They are giving darshan. They have some magic spell. So, you can put question, rice, dal, chapati, all material, Maharaj? Yes, all material. Yes. Right, all material. But when devotee, out of his devotion, pure devotion, when offering, then it becomes chinmay, his bhav. So no more it is material. No more it is material. Because Bhagavan Sri Krishna is explaining, if somebody, out of pure love, pure devotion, you are offering anything. Patram, puspam, phalam, toyam, jami, bhaktya, prajachati. Bhaktya mean? It is tritiya in Vyakaran. Third case in Vyakaran. Diyadara. Bhakti. Bhaktya. Jome, bhaktya pe. Bhakti dwara, bhakti ke dwara, peritho kar de raha hai. Jo me bhaktya prajachati, tadaham asnami. And Vishwanath Chakravarti explain, patram puspam phalam tuyam. What do you mean? If some devotee offering leaf, Vishwanath Chakravarti says, yes, Krishna can eat up. Even flower and leaf. Banana girls, yeah, already you have some evidence. Vidur, that when Krishna went to Vidur's house, Vidurani, the wife of Vidur, out of love, he forgets what she is offering to Krishna. Banana throwing, only the skin of banana offering to Krishna. Vidur coming? Come on, you are mad. What you are giving to Krishna? Why? You are throwing banana and giving skin? Krishna laughing. I am not taking banana. I am not taking any skin. I am taking her love. I am taking Baba Grai Janardhan. Krishna. So Vishwanath Chakravarti was explaining, any devotee is offering flower, leaf, anything. Krishna without any judgment taking it up. So you see, So everything is very secret philosophy, you see. How you can spiritualize the total function? Even Harikatha, you can find some material Harikatha. Harikatha material is not possible. I'm speaking this way, it seems that it is Harikatha. Like Gaur Kishore was speaking, there Navadip, Rani Chara, Kolodip, there is not Harikatha. It's like Harikatha. Like Harikatha, it's not actually. Harikatha means transcendental sound. You can feel. You can feel some reaction inside your heart if you hear. So Dadati Pratignati, this sloka you can apply, because Bhaktivinoda Thakur already told two kind of procedure. One is if you are in bonded condition, then you can carry out the order of Gurudev to serve prasadam. Anyway, you are not developing any kind of attachment with anybody there whom you ask. But now Brahmacharya, they are offering special prasad to one Mataji to get one relationship. Very sorry to speak. Yes, we see. Nobody there to speak anything against them. So this way, you can serve prasadam. You can run one society. Many outside people coming to you. Even one sweeper, who is doing sweeping job in temple, he is not actually sweeper. He is sweeper? Because in Puri I told that Bhaktivinoda Thakur identified himself as the sweeper of Namahatta. That Namahatta was started by Nityananda Prabhu. Nityananda Prabhu started in Surabhi Kunja. Surabhi Kunje Namer Hate. Nityananda Prabhu. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing nice kirtan. Nityananda Prabhu opening one market of Harinam there in Surabhi Kunja. And selling Harinam through agent. Through agent. Agent they are getting in fair price, they are getting wholesale rate, and they are coming to my. If they are going anywhere, they can retail price, they can sell. And what is the price? The price is sodhya. Price is sodhya, no money, nothing. Price is sodhya mulle. Only sodhya. Shraddha sabde kaye sudhiro vishas. Krishna bhakti kaile sarva karma kita. A strong belief. Sadhyan netam anusrenamad athavar nayedija. Bhaktim param bhagavatim pratilabdha kamam. Ridrogomasu pahinati achire nadhira. I can explain this point. Shraddha not a matter of joke. If you are 100% strong belief, if I do bhajan, Krishna bhajan, everything can be done. I have no other duty rather than Krishna bhakti. If you say, I have my duty, I have so many social duty, this duty, that duty, then you are not actually pure devotee. Many devotee coming to fight with me. If you speak this way, how we can run our society? Come on, man. How we can start? You cannot start, you cannot run society because you are violating Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. They are speaking wrongly. They are saying, if we at present, nowadays, if we follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada and Keshav Goswami Maharaj, we cannot run one society. What do you mean? They are speaking this way. At present, nowadays, if we follow Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Keshav Goswami Maharaj, we cannot run one society. Really? But I heard Guru Maharaj speaking many times that Gaudiya Math is guided by Prabhupada. Gaudiya Math, if you can follow Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, automatically you can run Gaudiya Math. You are not the driver of Gaudiya Math. You think you are driver, you are Acharya, big Acharya, you think? You are not the driver of Gaudiya Math. Who told you? You are driver? I heard Guru Maharaj speaking, Gaudiya Math is automatically driven by Gaur Hari, Vishambhar. Vishambhar means? Who can feed the whole world, infinity world. But still there is no deficit, no scarcity. So he is Vishambhar. Huh? Then they are out of false ego, they are fighting. We are running Gauriya Math, but you are speaking this way, we cannot run. I come on, man, if you go to home, it's good. If you go to home, it's good. We can run Gauriya Math nicely. Because I couldn't explain, because your Gurudev came, I got short time. It's chaos. I wanted to speak so many things. In Goldsmith house, you see Goldsmith house, Goldsmith shop, you can buy, they are sweeping, but totally opposite. You see? Goldsmith house, we sweep in room, we sweep and throw all garbage outside. But Goldsmith house, we see they are sweeping and taking all garbage inside their room. Why? I was very surprised. Someday I put a question, why you sweep oppositely? Maharaj, you know, our dust is very costly. Your dust costly? Yes. 10 people working there, goldsmith working. Yes. So what? Well, some particle going. So people, they are coming to buy our dust. Really so. So we as present, actually we are, we actually like goldsmith man. We are sweeping. Actually, Nityananda Prabhu, Namer heart, I can explain. I wanted to explain there, but I got puzzled. They actually, sweeper, we should act as a sweeper under the guidance of Nityananda Prabhu, under the guidance of Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Sastra, under the guidance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. What do you mean by sweeping? Sweeping means, it's very easy. You can sweep and throw all garbage outside. But what you are doing at present, you are opening one society, running one society, you are doing like goldsmith man. You are getting all garbage inside your room. I mean, you are buying some sort of problem. You are buying some sort of problem. All anartha you are buying. Bonded soul, they have the right to get diksha, provided they are 100% inclined. They want to get diksha. If they want to be rectified, otherwise don't give diksha. One example, again I can speak. So many examples I can give. One day, one devotee fighting with Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. Prabhupada, please you throw this devotee out of temple. Throw out. Why? He is doing so nonsense. What he is doing? Please, you throw him out of Gauriya Math gate. Prabhupada said, why? But he is doing all nonsense. Prabhupada saying, see, if some, those who are sick, they are automatically going to hospital. Sick people, where to go? We can go with them to hospital to get proper treatment. Prabhupada asking to that devotee. Who is requesting Prabhupada to throw him out of gate? Prabhupada speaking, first to tell me, what for this hospital is made? Gauriya Math is the number one hospital in the spiritual world. Spiritual hospital. They are sick people. They are coming to hospital. So is it my responsibility to throw them out of hospital or to treat them? Then that man again putting argument in front of Prabhupada. Then you can do one thing. You can all call thousands of people from road. You can do treatment to them. Prabhupada laughing. Yes. I can try to treat them, provided they can come to me and can speak, confess that I am sick, please do my treatment. At least they should. At least I expect they can come and speak, I am sick, please treat me. That man argue, putting argument with Prabhupada, then if you are putting this kind of argument, why not you go to road and call all people outside and you do treatment? Prabhupada, yes, I can do treatment. Brahmando tarite pare, brahmando tarite shakti dhare jane jane. Whole brahmanda, this spiritual world, I mean the material world. I can deliver. I can cite example from Chaitanya Charitamrita, the Vasudatta. Prabhupada, I request Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. What kind of blessing you need? I don't need anything, Prabhu, if you want. I want, if you can free those material bonded people, bonded Jivatma there in Brahmanda, if you can deliver them, that is my benediction. Oh my God, I want nothing. And you can get all their sufferings to me. I like to collect their suffering, I like to suffer. For infinity pure. Like from Bhagavatam, if I discuss some point, Rantidev. You can find the character of Rantidev. He is suffering so much, but he don't care. Because he find Krishna inside every heart. I can discuss this point if I discuss Bhagavatam. So, Gauranga Mahaprabhu laughing. Gauranga saying, you need not suffer for them. You need not suffer for them. It's very easy. You request me, request, I can request to Krishna. Krishna can deliver the whole universe. Like Ayodhya was totally free of material jiva. When Ayodhya, Ramchandra going to his eternal abode, full Ayodhya, Vasi, it seems they are material. But Ramchandra giving kipa to them. They are going, oh, passing away. Now Haridas Thakur asking, Prabhu, when Ramchandra gone, Ramchandra going to eternal abode, all bonded souls, then there is no bonded soul. There is vacant place. Haridas Thakur, no, again new Jivatma, Krishna can put there. Because countless. You have some finite conception. That's why you calculate, this gone, then where from? It's infinity. Where this question of infinity, there you cannot put any argument. Because infinity. I can discuss this point tomorrow, morning time. You can remember. Infinity. Infinity minus infinity is infinity. Infinity plus infinity is infinity. Follow. So this way, you should get in connection with infinity, I mean Nityananda. I can explain this point tomorrow. So, what I was discussing now, just a few minutes before, Namahatta. So, at present we are sweeping and getting some garbage inside our temple. Excuse me. I am speaking the truth. They can try to kill me, but still I am speaking the truth. We are all trying to get some garbage inside our temple. We have no capacity to clean the heart of our bonded devotee. Sweeping means to clean your heart. Oh, bonded soul coming. Yesterday he came. Oh, come on. I can give you the seva puja. We allow him to do puja? He is not bonded soul. He is not bonded soul. How you allow him? At least Kanishtha Adhikari, he should be in the form of Anisht Kanishtha Adhikari. Then you can allow him to do arshi, archan seva. Why you give red cloth to him? Red cloth means 75% sannyas. Red cloth means 75% sannyas. You should follow the rules and regulations, followed it by a pure sannyasi. But he is not bonded soul. His bed is not pure. Nothing is pure. How you can give? Not possible. So this kind of pure judgment should be there in every step. There should be pure judgment in each and every step. Then you can build up a nice society, spiritual organization, like Prabhupada. Otherwise, big problem. So Dadati, what time now?
8:40.
So Dadati Pratiginnati, you can understand? This kind of exchange, if you can do with a pure devotee, be sure that you are doing, you are successful, coming out successful. Understand? This way you have to do, pure devotee. Now I come back to the topic of Devahuti. Sango jo sanskriti rehto asasya bhito dhiya soyevo sadusu kritaha mokshadarum apavritam. Devahuti crying. Devahuti crying. And Kopildev giving nice advice. Any kind of association, mother, any kind of association you are doing in this your daily life, that is the cause of your bondage. That you can, that kind of bondage, association can put you inside bond, jail, can put you inside jail. You cannot get free. Sangojo sangsite reto, asasya bhito dhiya. Because sat and asat, for 1 year continuously you will have to discuss this point. What is sat, what is asat? Continuously harikatha. Still I don't know you can understand or not. So fine demarcation. So fine accuracy there. I cannot put any mathematical calculation like 0.00000001%. I cannot speak like that. So fine demarcation. If this way you can't, this court, then you are material layer. If you can't come this court, I mean two court, there's one Maya court, Maya world, and spiritual. So fine accuracy. So fine accuracy. So it's very, you should be very, very intelligent. I mean spiritual intelligent, not material intelligent. Je jan Krishna bhare she hai baruch chatur. A Chaitanya Bhagavad it is written, who is doing Krishna bhajan is very clever. A Krishna bhajan, who is doing Krishna bhajan, he is the Saitan of Saitan. He is the devil of devils. Oh, really? Yes. Because he know the technique how to engage that devil into Krishna seva. You know the technique how to engage him in Krishna seva, somehow to save him. So you see the patience of Haridas Thakur. If you want to become a preacher, then what kind of accuracy you should have? What kind of accuracy, what kind of, accuracy you should have? What kind of forbearing attitude, forbearing power? Humbler than the blade of grass, you can recite. Maharaj, Chaitanya Charitamrita, third clock, Trinada Vishnu Chaitanya, you can recite very quickly. But can you implement this sloka into your life? The day you are successful to implement this sloka in your life, then I promise with my upabit that you can come out successful. 100%. The day. The moment, not the day. The moment you come out successful. But can you give guarantee? This third sloka is a very tough sloka. Because by third sloka, you can understand the point whom to attend. About Harikatha, whom to attend. Because Jiva Goswami Pad giving one nice sloka, giving very restriction. Jiva Goswami Pad speaking. Those who have material attachment inside their heart, don't give the asana of Vyasadeva to them. Bhakta sarago nirago divido bhavet. Bhakta, who is a speaker, two kind of speaker you can find. Bhakta sarago nirago divido bhavet. It's a must. You can find two kind of speaker. One is without any attachment inside, how is speaking for only for your benefit, 100% benefit. And who is speaking to get clapping and money, pranami, big amount of pranami. Okay, at least we need pranami to guide, lead our life. Maharaj, never in my life I ask any benefit pranami from me. Still Krishna guiding me very properly. I print books costing lakhs of rupees, which is quite impossible for a man who has no second support other than Krishna. Nothing. I print books costing lakhs of rupees. I print 9 books at a time in Okhla, Delhi. Okhla, 9 books. Costing lakhs of rupees. How is possible to call, to print and give payment to the press man? Rukmo Press was the disciple of Narayan Maharaj. Rukmo Press. He took disciple. Hey, no credit. You will have to pay and take book out of. No credit. But still I was successful. How possible? Nisinga Parichajya, Bindadvi books, Bhakti Pramod Bhani Vaibhav, Chaitanya Chaitanya Sloka Udhriti, Bhagavad Mahatya. So many books. If you can 9 books at a time, come on man. How I was successful. Everything can be done if you depend upon Krishna Jagannath. The main fault is with you that you cannot believe a Vaishnava 100%. You cannot believe Krishna, Jagannath 100%. That is the main fault. Those who are pure devotees, they find somebody came to kill him. I can kill you. You will have to give this amount of money to me. They can fighting with pure devotees. But he don't think he is my shatru, enemy. A pure devotee never think he is asking money, he like to kill me, he like to put me in trouble, so he is enemy. A pure devotee never think like that. A pure devotee think Krishna is testing me through him. Krishna is putting me in testing, hard testing. If I can pass this exam, I can be elevated to the excellent level of Krishna Seva. Krishna, without testing, Krishna cannot take you. He can read any books. Vidagdha Madhav, Brahman Madhav, any books you can recite. That doesn't matter. Nil Madhav. But Krishna is going to test you heavily. You can do the worship of Narayan. You can, even you can do the worship of, I mean, I'm not advising. I'm joking with you. You can worship Mahadev and Durga. You can very, very quickly you can get, fulfill your target, material target. But Krishna is not going to respond to you so quickly. Very clever. Krishna is very clever. He is very clever, Krishna. Krishna is very clever. Whenever Krishna, I give one example, you can laugh. Someday Krishna was there in there in Sandipani Muni house to learn Vedanta, everything. Krishna was sent to Gurudev house, Brahmacharya, Krishna was observing. Someday Krishna was requesting to Sidham, a Sudama Vipra. Friend, I am very hungry. So what? So can you do one thing? There is a fried grain there inside the room of Gurudev. So I cannot enter. So can you enter then and get some grain from me? Fried grain. Chola Bhaja. Get from me? Oh, if somebody is seeing then. Nobody can see. I'm here. I can give you alert. No problem. He's going inside to get fried grain. At the same Krishna speaking to Guruma, wife of Sandipani Muni. Mother, he's going inside to steal grain. Going and catching him. Hey, you see? He is crying, Krishna speak me. In front of Krishna is crying. You are giving me advice to get some fried grain. At the same time, you are speaking to Guru Ma. He is stealing. What is your behavior? He is crying. Krishna seeing Krishna. Krishna speaking. Come on. I always test people this way. I always test you. I always be careful about my testing. Be careful about my testing. If you fail, you can pass exam. Higher secondary, school final, graduation. But this kind of testing is very hard. And Paramahansa never think that he is my enemy. He think this way, oh, maybe Krishna testing me this way. Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj in Navadip, in Navadip Dham, someday, oh, all naughty boys, they are throwing stone and mud. Hey, Baba, Baba, they are throwing. Gaur Kishore Babaji looking. Why you are beating me with stone and mud? You are disturbing me. Okay, let me go to Yashoda Amma. I can put complaint there. Let Gaur Kishore Babaji say, you are throwing stone to me, mud, disturbing me. Okay, now I am going to Yashoda Amma to lodge a complaint with Mataji. The thing is, Bhajadam, there is Krishna and Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Krishna and Nandi. This way. So this is not a matter of feeling, not a matter of joke. Don't think that way. So tough feeling. Gyananishta viraktova madbhaktova anapekshakaha sa linganam asramam stakta charid abhidhi goshara. They are banned any rules and regulation. Paramahansa. He cannot put any restriction. Because all the 24 hours they are doing bhajan. Hey! Babaji Maharaj not attending kirtan morning. Babaji Maharaj not attending arati time. Where Babaji Maharaj is there? Eh? We don't find Babaji Maharaj. He think he is Babaji Maharaj like my, me, has bonded so. So see, I told you, Nam Kirtan, Sravan Kirtan is a mode of bhajan. Topmost. Ninefold of bhajan mode there, Navavida Bhakti. Out of that you can find Savana Kirtan, Savan Kirtan, top. So you are doing bhajan, you are taking the help of Savan Kirtan. But what about Paramahansa Babaji Maharaj? Savan Kirtan is the mode of his bhajan. He like to get siddhi out of Savan. He is already siddha. So for you, it is the mode of bhajan. For Paramahansa Babaji Maharaj, Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj, Bansidas Babaji, Jagannath Babaji Maharaj, Savan Kirtan itself a target. I mean, Prayojan Tattha. Be careful, very top secret. Which is the bhajan mode for you? Sadhan. You are doing sadhan. But that Savan Kirtan is a not sadhan procedure, that sadhan for that Paramahansa is already target for him. I mean, Prayojan Tattha. Through Savan Kirtan, he is meeting Krishna. Follow. Very secret point. Otherwise, you can make confusion. You can fight with one pure Vishnu. For them, Savan Kirtan is Prayojan Tattva. They are already meeting, getting Prayojan Tattva through Savan Kirtan. So that's why yesterday I told Gopikas, they are citing Tava kathamritam tapta jivanam kavividitam kalmasapaham savanamangalam simadatatam bhuviginantite bhuridayana. I spoke yesterday. But do you think Gopikas, they are doing sadhana? Bonded so? No. By Savan Kirtan, they are meeting Krishna. In Bhramar Gita, you should not discuss this point. At all, if you do after 20, 25 years after, if you get that kind of platform, then even you will have to hear from the lotus mouth of a very pure devotee. Yeah. Uddhava Sangmad, Bhramar Gita. In Uddhava Sangmad, Bhramar Gita, Bhramar Gita, there you can find Radharani crying and speaking. We can try to throw Krishna out of our heart because it is a burning feeling. We can try to keep Krishna, throw Krishna out of your heart because a burning feeling we feel inside our heart. But anyway, come on, we cannot live this Harikatha. We cannot leave Kirtan. Follow me. Gopikas, they are speaking. Tat katha dustajya tat katha. Tat katha means Krishna katha dustajya. कृष्ण को छोड़ने के लिए हम कोशिश कर सकता, बट उसका हरि कथा जो है वो कीर्तन जो है दैट वी कैन नॉट, वेरी सीक्रेट सिद्धांत ही है, वेरी सीक्रेट, बिकॉज थ्रू हरि कथा दे आर मीटिंग कृष्ण। व्हेन राधारानी गो फेंट मूर्छा मूर्छा, देन ललिता विशाखा सिंह हरे कृष्ण 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 स्पीकिंग श्याम श्याम श्याम, समटाइम आफ्टर गेट कॉन्शियस, हु सिंग श्याम नाम इन फ्रंट ऑफ मी, द श्याम द साउंड कमिंग इन टू माई ईयर एंटरिंग इन टू हार्ट गिविंग सम निक्टेरियन फीलिंग, हु इज हु यू giving benefit to me, who you are, I think you are my friend, topmost friend, like Gaur Hari Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Same thing, if you like to follow Gauranga Mahaprabhu, you must follow one pure devotee, who is not sahajya. In every moment that devotee can prove that you are running sahajya way, every fraction of moment he can prove you. Every moment he can prove from Chaitanya Bhagavad, Chaitanya Bhagavad, everywhere, or with through all evidence. Be careful. If you follow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I mean, if you can have the chance to get the all, to get all the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then you are very lucky. Then you can understand the feeling of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu with Radha Bab, with Radha Bab. My topic today, what do you mean by good association? How to avoid evil association? Within these topics I am running, hovering around this topic. But still I need to go here and there. What to do? So now, tomorrow I have the chance to speak Hari Katha, because tomorrow I think I have to do worship, because that Maharaj can go. Anyway, I can try. I can leave worship. I can do worship after. So, from tomorrow, I can try to discuss Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's teaching, how to get good association, how to avoid evil association. Under the light of Chaitanya Siksha, Chaitanya Sikshamitam, we can try to understand. Then in our whole life, I think if you can get all my points, what I wanted to speak, 100%, then I can put guarantee. Evil association is not at all possible in your life who attained my Harikatha. By the blessing of Gurudev and Prabhupada, I put guarantee. But I am not sure if you are not attaining Harikatha perfectly. So from tomorrow, my topics is to clarify this point. Rupa Goswami Pada's, everything I can discuss. And one thing from Bhagavatam I like to speak now. Rajastama prakatayo samasila vajanti boi. Rajastama prakatayo samasila vajanti boi. This point I can clear, make clear tomorrow morning first. Okay? And today I can stop my speech, I think. I have some other seva. Sango yo sanskriti heto asasva vihito diya sa evo sadhu sukrataha mokshadharam apavritam. वांछा कल्पतरुवस्य के बासिंद व्यवच पतितानं पावने भविष्यभ्यो नमो. नाउ टाइम 9 o'clock, आई थिंक एग्जैक्ट 9. माताजी कमिंग लेट, आई कैन गिव पेनल्टी टू यू, यू हैव टू गिव पेनल्टी बिकॉज माताजी हियरिंग मी. हां, एनी क्वेश्चन? नो, ऑल आंसर आई गिवन. एक्चुअली देयर कैन नॉट बी एनी क्वेश्चन. Somebody in my Harikatha, somebody putting question, or some devotee, and I say, hey, don't stop. You can get answer after Harikatha is over. You can get it. Stop now. So, Vancha Kalputra Vastika. Chalo. So, chalo. Huh? Who? Who?
Omaraj, you got question.
What? What question?
Yesterday, you touched the point about mother, affectionate mother, which pulls many things. But it's not good for liver.
Cannot digest, so he should be alert about before taking prasadam. So nice prasadam. See, liver condition is not good. He cannot digest, so better he can check before taking prasadam.
Yeah, but what does it mean in aspect of Siddhanta.
Because sometimes some elevated Vaishnava, they are giving so nice philosophy in front of you. Some Guru Vaishnava become very careful, I cannot speak in front of them, because they can misunderstand. Some Acharya, they are more liberated. I can speak if some of them can attend. In that case, you should be very careful, because Gurudev is like mother affection among giving. I have no right to take. I cannot digest. So I cannot blame that Acharya. And one thing more, I can request you to go through Bhajan Rasya, go through Bhakti, Vinod, Vani Vaibhav, please, this is my request. You can find each and every step, I am speaking all about Bhakti Vinod Thakur, about Prabhupada and Bhakti Vinod Thakur. You can discover. Yes, Sam Baba not speaking out of Bhakti Vinod Thakur and Prabhupada. Otherwise you can misunderstand me, he is speaking so heavy. Why? I request you go through Chaitanya Bhakti, you go through Bhakti Vinod Vani Vaibhav, Bhajan Rasya, you go, please. Then you can understand what I am speaking. Then you cannot become angry with me. My Chaturmasa going on, so big year and this. Actually, I cannot go to Ceylon. You can misunderstand me. Some devotee there with me, he leave. At the time of Purnima, I don't find actually busy all the day, and he leave. I cannot go to Ceylon. So let be it. I cannot save my beard. This way I grow my nail and this are like ghost. Please excuse me. So, chalo.
No, he asking if somebody inspired by one Vaishnava and got Harinam from him. After that he attacked by another Vaishnava and he got Diksha from that another Vaishnava. This is right process or maybe some exception?
Actually, as per scriptural analysis, as per Sanatana Goswami path, if you can get Harinam from one nice devotee, and after that if you get attraction, then if you think that he is a proper guidance you can get, then Diksha you can get from the second Vaishnava. But suppose you get Harinam and Diksha from previous, you already got. In that case, if he is in Madhyamadhikari, still you cannot leave him. Until and unless you discover some fault for others, understand. Until and unless you find some big fault with him, you cannot leave him. It's not the rules. You can follow him and you can take advice from that devotee, from that Acharya, that Maharaj, you allow me to get the association of that devotee who is speaking Harikatha this way. If Maharaj says, yes, you can go. Then you can get both. Because Shikshaguru, Bhikshaguru, unique tattva. It seems there is a different tattva. You can get permission, we can get him as our Shikshaguru. Maharaj is Nirmatsar. Maharaj says, yes, you can go attend his Haripada. Then both you can fulfill your target. No need of leaving him. You cannot leave him. You got Harinam, suppose he is a nice Vaishnav, you get the cup from him. Understand? Sometimes some Vaishnav, he is not giving Diksha. Sometime. Not giving Diksha. Only Acharan, like Acharya and speaking Harikatha. And through Diksha, he is acting as Acharya. Through Diksha, he can give the actual meaning of Diksha inside your heart. So he is also Acharya. And I am very unlucky, Bhakti Vidyan Bharati Maharaj and very big Vaishnava, they order me directly, you must give Diksha. Bharati Maharaj told this way, you must give Diksha. I said, you must dig Diksha. I told Maharaj, you should dig Diksha. This way Maharaj told repeatedly. But I think I should not, because I am not Acharya. I can speak Harikatha that much. This way. This way I can. Bharati Maharaj elevated so. I think he is Sikha Guru, my Sikha Guru. I always think. He loves me, respect me. Maybe he is testing me. Maybe he is testing me with his speech, very clever. So, he cannot defeat me. Okay, dandavad, eh? Chalo. He is a disciple of?
Who?
Huh? Why? Oh, I saw you many times. I forget your face. I saw you many times. then what question?
You said Bhagavad Mahatmya you published.
Huh? What?
Bhagavad Mahatmya you published.
Yes, Bhagavad Mahatmya twofold. One is from Skanda Puran, one is Padma Puran. Padma Puran, I published the Bhagavad Mahatmya of Skanda Puran.
Is it in Sanskrit?
No, actually Sanskrit, and some meaning is there in Bengali.
Okay.
Sanskrit, Bengali script, because many devotees, they cannot read Sanskrit directly.
Tika, Samtika there?
Huh?
Samtika is there?
Tika, I mean.
Yes. Can I
get it? Actually, I am madman, you see. I have nobody to maintain myself. So I print 10 books and distribute. And they sell. I don't get money. I don't never take money. I distribute to Devananda Gaudiamath here, there. They sell. After that, I find, discover, no books, even a single copy is there with me. So these are all, they chide me. Maharaj, you are actually I am foolish. I never maintain any file, anything. Oh, I don't have time.
But where can I find it?
I will have to search. If you have any sample copies there, in my library, I can try. I can get for you. But otherwise, no chance, because I distribute all book. Take. After that, finish. Only cover page I can see. He got picture of cover page.
Talk about Aparadharma in the coming few days.
What?
Along with speaking about association, can you also let us know about little about Aparad?
Yes, you need not see. I can go on speaking automatically.